variation in the diagnosis of corneal dystrophy.
It's not going ahead.
The clinical diagnosis in corneal dystrophies can be established based on the age of onset, the characteristic appearance, depth and pattern of opacities on slit lamp biomicroscopy. Different phenotypes of the same corneal dystrophy may have varying manifestations, and certain corneal inflammatory conditions and scars may show secondary degenerative changes which look like corneal dystrophies. Therefore, the diagnosis of corneal dystrophy becomes challenging. Histopathologic tissue diagnosis of the corneal button remains the gold standard in diagnosis. Aims and objectives of my study were to study the clinico-pathological correlation in the diagnosis of corneal dystrophies in patients who underwent keratoplasty, to study the improvement in the best corrected visual acuity, and to study the recurrence rates. This was a retrospective study in 90 eyes of 86 patients who were clinically diagnosed with corneal dystrophy and underwent either penetrating or lamellar keratoplasty from 2010 to 2019 at Shankar Netralaya, Chennai, with a follow-up period of 1 year. All the corneal buttons underwent histopathological processing, that is, they underwent staining by H&E and PAS. Special stains were used to confirm the diagnosis. Other histopathological findings like corneal epithelial thickness, irregularity, the Bowman's interruptions, stromal scarring, Desmet's membrane changes, and gutte, along with endothelial cell loss, were also assessed. This is a picture showing amyloid material in lattice corneal dystrophy stained with hematoxylin and eosin. This is a picture showing Congoret stain in lattice corneal dystrophy and the characteristic apple green birefringence under polarized light. This is hyaline material in granular corneal dystrophy staining bright red with Mason trichrome stain. These are acid mucopolysaccharides and glycosaminoglycan material in macular corneal dystrophy stained with alchin blue. This is a picture of a patient with Fuchs endothelial corneal dystrophy, HNE staining, showing thickened Desmet's membrane and wart formation and endothelial degeneration. Coming to results, clinically, macular dystrophy was diagnosed in 47% of the cases, Fuchs followed by Fuchs in 22%, granular dystrophy in 14%, lattice dystrophy in 10%, 3.3% were diagnosed as CHED, and 2.2% eyes had gelatinous dewdrop dystrophy and Rees Buchler's dystrophy. The clinical diagnosis was confirmed histopathologically by histopathologically on tissue diagnosis using special stains in 90% of the eyes. The Fuchs endothelial corneal dystrophy, CHED, and gelatinous dewdrop dystrophy were accurately diagnosed clinically. All three cases of Avellino dystrophy were misdiagnosed. Avellino dystrophy was diagnosed in two eyes as lattice corneal dystrophy and as granular corneal dystrophy in one eye. Granular corneal dystrophy was misdiagnosed as macular in one eye and Rees Buchler's in two eyes. The macular was misdiagnosed as lattice in one eye and granular corneal dystrophy in two eyes. This is because Avellino dystrophy shows features of both lattice and granular dystrophy, and there is a clinical overlap in the presentation of granular and macular corneal dystrophies. The variations in the clinical appearance of the corneal opacities and the pre-existing corneal scarring makes the diagnosis difficult. Our study had a median BCVA of 6/9, and more than 95.5% eyes had a best corrected visual acuity of 6/36 or more. This is a clinical picture of patient in our study with granular corneal dystrophy pre-op and then post-op 2 weeks after DALC. This is a pre-op picture of a patient with Fuchs endothelial corneal dystrophy pre-op and then post-op DSEC 2 weeks post-op. The complications noted in our study were graft rejection in 3 eyes, glaucoma in 2 eyes, and recurrence in 6 eyes. All 6 cases of recurrence were following lamellar keratoplasty. The highest rate of recurrence was in gelatinous dewdrop dystrophy and followed by granular and then lattice corneal dystrophy. These are pictures showing the recurrences, the first picture of granular dystrophy and lattice dystrophy, both following DALC. The pattern of dystrophies observed in our study was similar to the study by Sultan Alizueri et al. In 2015, with macular being the most common. This is in contrast to the study by David C. Muish et al. In 2011, which found endothelial dystrophies to be the most common. The difference may be attributed to the fact that ours was a study of patients who underwent keratoplasty and not a prevalence study. The post-operative visual acuity in our study was better than 6/36 in 95.5% of the eyes, which was comparable to the study by Ashik Mohammed et al. In 2018. Both the studies had a median best corrected visual acuity of 6/9. The recurrence rates in our study were highest for gelatinous dewdrop and granular corneal dystrophy, followed by lattice. These findings are comparable to the ones by Marcon, AS et al., who studied recurrence of corneal stromal dystrophies after PK in Wills Eye Hospital. In conclusion, I would like to say corneal dystrophies can be accurately diagnosed clinically based on patient history, presentation, and thorough biomicroscopic examination. The systematic histopathological evaluation, including special stains, provide ancillary support to establish the correct diagnosis, especially in Avellino dystrophy, which may have a confusing clinical picture.
Thank you.
Which were the stains you used for diagnosing these dystrophies?
Ma'am, for the granular dystrophy,
For the hyaline stains, for lattice we used Congoret, for granular Mason trichrome, and for the macular dystrophy we used Alchin blue. Colloidal iron stain was also used.
Thank you.
So for macular dystrophy, the treatment of choice was
DAL
or PK?
Depending on how much of the which layers were involved, it was both were done, ma'am. In our study, both the procedures were done. So there was no treatment of choice based on patient to patient.
Also
involved, yes, ma'am. So we've seen how much of the involvement of the corneal layers was there, and then decided on the procedure. No hard and fast rule.
Thank you.